Audio in video is very important. I think we can all agree on that.
Bad sound is just not pleasant for your audience to listen to.
So that's why we're taking a look today inside Adobe Premiere Pro on how to improve your speech and make your voice sound very warm and pop out. What's up guys, Jordan here for Cinecom.net, and today we're going to improve the speech of a very typical scenario here. I am vlogging, so that means I've got my microphone on the camera. Let's have a listen to it. What up guys, Jordan here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone on top of my camera. So that's definitely not ideal, but a very common situation. So let's get started on that audio, and what I'm gonna do first is kind of select this and duplicate it with holding down my Alt key to audio track number 2. And that way we can listen to the before and the after that we've applied all the effects to it. So for now, I'm going to mute the first track and work on the second one. What we're gonna do is use the audio essentials from the latest update of Adobe Premiere Pro. And to locate that essentials audio panel, you wanna head over to the window here on top and select the essentials audio. There we go. Or it's actually essential sound. So this right here is a dialogue. So from the options here, I will also pick out dialogue. And Premiere here made it very easy for us. What it's actually doing in the background is analyzing this sound clip. And therefore, we can just make changes with one slider or just one click of a button. It doesn't always work that well, I do have to mention that, but it definitely works good in most occasions. Now, anyways, while we are going to change one of these settings, we can always dive into the details, and we'll have a very quick look at that, because I don't want to dive too much into the details. I want to keep this tutorial basic so that you know what to do with just a few clicks. We're going to start by repairing this clip, because if we're going to take a listen, you will hear this noise, this disturbing sound on the background.
Top of my camera.
Something very common, you know, things like traffic in the background or an air conditioning or a refrigerator in the background making noise. We want to make sure that that is gone. So I'm going to click here on repair, and I'm going to select the reduce noise option. And now you just kind of have to listen and see what it does. You want to make sure that the noise is kinda gone, because that will affect the voice too much. Let's have a listen.
Phone on top of my camera.
That's pretty okay. If I'm going to increase this too much, you will hear what it does to my voice.
A microphone on top of my camera.
It's actually still holding up pretty well. You just want to make sure that you are avoiding to have a robotic voice. You know, something that was recorded on a very old cell phone or something. Now, often Premiere will kind of analyze your clip a little bit wrong. What you can then do is, with this clip selected that you're working on, head over to the effects controls on top, and here you will see the effect that has been applied to that clip by enabling that option here. And from here, this is the adaptive noise reduction. I'm going to click on edit, which will reveal some more options. And what I can do in here, I can see here that Premiere is doing a reduction of 24 decibels, which is sometimes a bit much. You can decrease that then right here to something, let's say, around minus 15 dB. And then the second option is how much noise is there in the background. Also something that you can play with, of course. And let me just exaggerate for a moment here. I'm going to do this. I'm going to set this to 100. And let's listen now to the sound.
.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone.
And this is definitely too much. You can now hear that robotic voice. So I'm going to decrease that again to something around 50%. It should do okay.
And this is an audio test indoor with a microphone on top of my camera.
And the noise is definitely a little bit gone, so that is good. Like I said before, we can't remove it entirely. The next thing I want to do is kind of make my voice a bit more present. And to do that, we're going to use here under the clarity, the dynamics. And this is the only thing that we have to do, just enable that and just kind of increase that dynamics setting. And again, this is something that you have to play with. Set a certain value. Usually dynamics can be set at something around 6, 7, or even 8, and then just play it back and listen to the sound.
What up guys, Jordan here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test.
And listening to the before.
What up guys, Jordan here for Cinecom.
I definitely made it a bit more present, and I believe I can even increase this to a 10. Let's listen.
Jordan here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone.
All right, this is now a bit too much. Let's put this back to maybe 9. Like I said before, it's something that you have to play with. Every recording is differently.
Guys, Jordan here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone on top of my camera.
I'm very happy with this result. It gives the voice a bit more punch to it. The next setting is going to be an equalizer, and I'm going to use the equalizer to make my voice a bit warmer. This is definitely something that you have to do if you are working with a microphone on top of your camera. By the way, guys, I haven't said this before, but if you are doing studio recordings, the same things apply. There's just different values that you're setting. So, deselect the equalizer effect that will apply a new effect to your clip. And actually, this time, I want to go into the settings of this effect. I don't want to go to the presets here, because the essential sound doesn't have too much in here to tweak my voice. So I'm going to click here on edit for the graphic equalizer. And there are a couple of things here that I want to do. First thing is remove all the low frequencies. On the left side here, we can find all the low tones. And on the right side are all the high frequencies. And usually those are nasty sounds like refrigerators and stuff. So I'm also going to just put that all the way down. Just cut off those sounds. What we're actually doing here is a high cut and a low cut. Then the next thing in the voice is usually a very nasty sound. And I want to locate that by exaggerating each band in here and kind of look where that is at. So what I'm going to do is set the program monitor here on loop playback. And if you can't find this button here, then click on this plus button to find that loop option and just drag that button to your toolbar of the program monitor. So make sure that is selected, and now when you are going to play your clip in a timeline, it will actually loop that clip. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to increase the 8 kilohertz, 4 kilohertz, 2 kilohertz, and so on. And usually that nasty sound is going to be somewhere around the 1K, 2K, sometimes 4K. So let's play it back.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone on top of my camera. What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone.
So it's definitely the 2K. As you can hear, this is a very nasty sound here.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net.
And this is something that we have to reduce a tiny bit. Usually in studio recordings, that is going to be around 1K. And if you're filming with a microphone on top of your camera, then it's the 2K. So let's just decrease that here a tiny bit. Something around minus 10 would do. I'm just going to bring this other values here back to zero, set them a default, and only decrease here this 2K value here a tiny bit. Let's have a listen to it.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and
this sounds a lot better now. The next thing I want to do is make my voice a bit warmer, and those warm sounds are in the low frequencies. And we kind of want to create this arc here going towards that 2 kilohertz. So I'm going to increase some of these lower frequencies, something like this, as you can see, creating this arc. And you can also see it very good here in this graph in the essential sounds panel. And let's just have a listen to it.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net.
This actually sounds pretty good.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net. And this is an audio test.
Don't exaggerate with these settings here in the equalizer. It's usually just a very subtle setting that you want to do. And sometimes if you think that dynamics processing that we've done before didn't do its job too well on the higher frequencies, making your voice more present, then you can increase your 4 kilohertz or 8 kilohertz a tiny bit here. So let's do that and listen to how that sounds.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio
All right, that actually sounds pretty nice. I'm going to leave it with that. The last thing that I want to do is not from the essential sounds, actually, but from the effects library, and I've already searched for it before. Right here, the heart limiter. It's inside your audio effects folder. I'm going to drag this effect onto my clip that I was working on, and what this will do is kind of push the volume of my speech all the way up and kind of compress that audio. It's going to make sure that the audio is not going to clip with all of these effects that we've added to its prior, and also going to make sure that it's not going to be too low. So it's going to help you with setting that volume as well. With that heart limiter here, I'm going to press on the edit button, and from the presets, I'm going to select the limit to 0.1 decibel, or actually minus 0.1 decibel. And let's have a listen to it right now. And also, let's have a look here. These two blocks right here, they cannot be red. If they are red, then your sound is clipping. So let's play this back, and it should not happen with this limiter.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone on top of my camera.
So that is wonderful. Now let's listen to the before and the after. This is the before.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test.
And now let's listen to the after.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test.
And that is much better. My voice is more present, warmer, and we've reduced that background noise a tiny bit. The next thing that I want to do is set some music underneath this. And it's not just about decreasing the volume of that music clip to hear my voice, there's actually a bit more that we have to do. So I'm going to go back to my clips folder right here, and this right here is an awesome song that I got from premiumbeat.com. I also want to thank those guys for sponsoring this video here again. Let's listen to it. This right here, guys, is a song that I got from premiumbeat.com. I want to thank those guys as well for sponsoring this video again. It's an awesome song that we're also using for an after movie at the moment. And we're doing this fast cutting onto it, and we're definitely going to make a video about that as well very soon. Now, guys, you can find the path to this song in the description below. And yes, you see what I just did there. It will bring you to this page right here, guys, and you can listen to the different loop sets that this song has as well. And that way you can kind of create your own custom song from this music file, and that is something pretty cool. So make sure to visit premiumbeat.com for high quality, royalty-free music and sound effects. So let's work with this awesome song. It's very nice, but it does come with a couple of problems. Let's listen to the higher frequencies in this song. And that are a bunch. And when we are going to decrease the volume, those higher frequencies from this song are actually going to interrupt a little bit with my speech. Now that is of course something that we can fix with the essential sound. So let's do that. I'm going to delete here the untreated sound because we're not going to listen to the before and the after of that again. And let me just drag in this clip into the timeline like so. I'm going to make this a bit longer and drag my clip here into the middle like that. Now what you usually want to do is take your pen tool here from the toolbox and kind of create keyframes to lower the volume of that music clip. So right before the speech starts, you create a keyframe, you kind of lower that volume, usually to something around minus 15. It really depends on the type of song that you have like that. Create a new keyframe when the speech ends and lift your volume back up after that. Let's play this back and have a listen.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone on top of my camera.
And this is actually going pretty well, but we might even be able to push this volume a bit more, minus 10 dB.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test.
All right, this is good. We have a nice presence of the music now in the background, a little bit too present, and that's because of those high frequencies. So what I'm gonna do now is kind of push those high frequencies down. So I'm going to take my blade tool here from the toolbox and just cut right in this transition right here, and also here on the ends like that. And I'm going to apply an effect on through here. With this selected, I'm going to go to the essential sound, and instead of music, I'm actually going to pick out dialogue. Because there's a setting here, the equalizer, and I'm actually going to use the background voice equalizer, because as you can see, it kind of selected the higher frequencies, which is exactly what we need. I'm going to increase this amount so that it will push down those higher frequencies. You can also just drag in the equalizer effect onto that clip, but I find this pretty useful, pretty fast. And let's play this back now and let's have a listen.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio
And now that music is not bothering so much anymore because those lower frequencies has been pushed down. Now, in order to make sure that we're not cutting so fast between having no equalizer and then suddenly having an equalizer between these two, I'm going to right-click on this cut and say apply default transition, and that will add this cross-dissolve over it so that we slowly transition to that equalizer effect and also on the end. So let's have a listen to the end result. This is just one awesome song.
What up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and this is an audio test indoor with a microphone on top of my camera.
Isn't that sounding great? Alright, guys, that was it again for this pretty long tutorial, but I do hope that you've learned something new and that you can apply these tips into your next creative project. I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and always remember, stay creative.